Greetings. I've been expecting someone like you to come. Just give me a moment while I replace some herbs in my potion cabinet. While you wait, why not sit down and make yourself comfortable? I'll be there before you can even say moonlight. Welcome to my humble shop. How may I be of service to you today, kind stranger? Let me take a guess. Judging from your purposely discreet cloak, you're not supposed to be here, aren't you? You ran away from somewhere important. Surely you know of my reputation around this area. They do not take kindly of people associated with the mystic realm. I disguise my shop as a simple medicine store, but you're not here for some cheap elixir, aren't you, Your Majesty? What have I done for you to treat me so lowly, Your Highness? I only take payments after I've done my services. And gold is not what our kind would particularly consider valuable. I've heard some rumors about you. You're the next in line in the throne, the only child of the king and queen. How wonderful for you. This kingdom is one of the most powerful across the world. No one dares to challenge the potential that this kingdom possesses. And soon, that power will be handed down to you. You'll have all the riches that this world can buy right at your fingertips. So, forgive me for being very curious. What do you need my services for? You want to see the future? That is a very simple question. But the answer could be anything. If I may ask again, what part of your future do you want to see? Forgive me, Your Highness. I did not expect such an innocent answer. I was for sure you were about to ask something related to the kingdom's expenditures. If it will someday perhaps conquer all the other lands. But you're different, aren't you? You do not care about such things. You're still young and naive. You only want to see who you'll eventually marry. I must say, I find your character very endearing. So much so that looking into your future will be entertaining for me as well. Now come, make haste. I am as elated as you are. Let us take a journey deep into your soul. Now, as preparations, remove your cloak and gloves. I will need you to place your hand into this basin of water. Do you have any jewelry on you? Good. Material wealth is seen as impure by the gods of the stars. We do not want to displease them when we are asking for a favor now. Don't we? Here, hold my hand tightly, and whatever you do, do not let go, or else the spell will be broken, and we will be punished for disrespecting them. Are you ready? Before anything else, I must warn you, the future may not hold what you desire, as there are thousands of stars in the sky. There will be thousands of possibilities that lie ahead of us. Do you understand these conditions? Very well. If you may close your eyes. Ustendem mihi facem, abisia parum quod scriptum est in astris, ubi cor est mendaciat quod cupio. Now, open your eyes. What do you see?
I never wanted to be your friend. I wanted to be your girlfriend.
Indeed, you may look different, but it is your soul that's harboring that body. You've met a lovely girl, golden hair, and heart as strong as the finest stone. Can you see how earnest she is? I could practically feel her love for you. It's deep, like a longing for something to set them free. You have set them free. This is quite strange. There is another string in this timeline. A fiery girl with a lonely heart.
Well, there are times when I can feel the silence inside of my house, but it comforts me knowing that I could just call you and you will show up.
She's thankful for you. You are the starlight in her dark and desolate world. This is good news. It seems that you're blessed by the gods, gifted with the purest forms of love. But this is too far into the future. You'll never get to meet her in your lifetime. It seems like you have broken this girl's heart. Pitiful. I sense a strong feeling of regret and sadness in her soul. Luckily for you, this is still too far. Long after the kingdoms have passed, you'll never see her either. We need to go back even more. Back to the nearest future ahead. Wait, this can't be. It is us? We look so happy together, without a care in the world. You are my destiny. This is unbelievable. Never in my whole life would I imagine that I would meet my other half. You fool! Did you not remember what I just said? Never to let go of my hand, or else you'll face the consequences from the gods? What? Do you think I just made all of that up? I told you beforehand, there will be thousands of possibilities in the future. We were just not expecting our destinies to cross so soon. How callous of you, coming into my shop, believing that I have the power to see the future, and then rejecting my predictions? The nerve of you royalties. I cannot stand it. Why? Are you ashamed that your destined partner is nothing but a lonely fortune teller? Were you perhaps expecting a pure-hearted maiden of royal blood across the ocean to be your beloved? This is not my fault. Do not pour your disbelief at me. What I see is true, even if you do not accept it. Fine, then leave. You're nothing but a child who cries and whines when they do not get what they want. I do not wish to see you either. Never in my life again.
Thank you.